Deduction of Coulomb's law from Gauss theorem. Now consider an isolated positive point charge located at center O of a sphere, say something like this, and the radius of the sphere is some r, and suppose we consider a small portion of area, say ds over here, and electric field through this area would be somewhat like this, E. This area is ds, and the area vector for this area would be some n cap. Now, according to Gauss theorem, we have the surface integral of E dot ds would be equivalent to total charge divided by epsilon naught. Now, as we see, the angle between the electric field and the area vector is 0 degree as these two are parallel. Therefore, we can express this dot product as E dot ds cos of 0 is equal to Q upon epsilon naught. Now, cos 0 is 1, so further simplifying, we get Q upon epsilon naught. E we can take outside the integration symbol, thus we write E surface integral of ds Q upon epsilon naught. Now ds on integration would give the total surface area of the sphere, which is 4 pi r square, as we already know from mensuration formula. So this would be 4 pi r square Q upon epsilon naught, and ultimately electric field's equation we will get as 4 pi epsilon naught r square. Now this is the electric field intensity at any point at a distance r from a charge Q. Now if another charge Q naught is placed over here, then the force experienced by that charge would be F is equal to electric field into Q naught. And electric field we have from the above expression as Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught r square and into Q naught. On writing it properly, it would be Q into Q naught upon 4 pi epsilon naught r square, and this is the Coulomb's law for the force of attraction and repulsion between two charges kept at a distance r from each other. Hence, Coulomb's law is derived from Gauss theorem.